Keep going. 14. And of course, 15. So legs apart, holding your hands from straight. 1, 2, back straight. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course, 15. One set down, two more to go. Our rest time starts now. Our rest time starts now. So all you need to do is walk around, breathe in and out. By the way, that felt good. I was still half asleep though. But that first set woke me up. That first set woke me up. That first set woke me up. Alright. Alright. Our time's up. Our time's up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, move. Oh, alright. There's 1. There's 2. There's 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. 11. 12. 13. 14. End of class. That is 15. Legs apart. There we go, swing under. 1, legs straight. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course, 15. Well done. Your rest time starts now. Your rest time starts now. Walk around. You have one more set of that for warm up. One more set. One more set of that for warm up. One more set for warm up. One more set for warm up. We have 5 more seconds. 5 more seconds to go. 5 more seconds to go. 5 more seconds to go. Hands up. All right. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, move. All right. 1. All right. There we go. 3, all the way up. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course, 15. Well done. Legs apart, arms up, swing under. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,
11, leg straight, 12, 13, 14, and of course, 15. Well done, well done. Now I know you're fully awake. Our rest time starts now. Our rest time starts now. Walk around, walk around, walk around. All right. Walk around, walk around. Breathe in. Breathe in. We have 10 more seconds. Breathe in and out. So our next workout, basically, what we're going to do, we're going to get into a push-up position. So, like sort of a push-up plank position. So you'll be here, right, like that. You take your arms there, then that. Arms there, then that. So that's one. So we're going to do 8 of those. All right, times 3. We're going to do 8 of those times 3. Now, for example, you can't do a full push-up. What do? So you'll be here. You'll be up there, go up there, then go to your knee, there, then here, there, go to your knee, that. All right. So we are going to do 8. This side and this side is 1, which means 2 push-ups is equal to 1. We are going to do 8 times 3. Are you ready? It's an upper body day. So let's get started. 1, 2, 3, move. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done, well done, well done. If you did that first set successfully, those are 8. Your rest time starts now. Make sure you're stretching them as you go along. In your rest period, and you just walk around, walk around, walk around. It's an upper body day. We started with tricep and chest, all right? We started with the tricep and chest. Started with the tricep and chest. Hands up. Set number 2 of that routine, set number 2. Let's go.1, 2, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you're doing well. And of course, 8. Well done. Well done. So we're going to do chair dips. Grab your chair onto the mat, right? So you're going to put your body weight on your arms while you're lifting yourself up. We're going to do 12 times 3. Are you ready? Yes, 12 times 3. So this is how you hold the chair. You grab it like that, all right? So we're going to go down and up. So basically something like down and up. All right, so we're going to do 12 times 3. Starting now. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3 and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and of course 12. Well done. Well done. Our rest time starts now. Our rest time starts now. Look around. Look around. Look around. Our rest time starts now. Walk around, walk around. We have 5 more seconds to go. To our next set, 5 more seconds. 5 more seconds. Time's up. Let's go for set number 2. Set number 2. 1, 2, 3 and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and of course 12. Well done. Well done. Our rest time starts now. Hey, naizo mnafanya haraka. But don't use your legs to lift yourself up. Pivot using this muscle here. I don't know if you can see. My mind is coming through. Alright. Alright, alright. We have 10 more seconds of rest. 10 more seconds of rest. 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds. We have 5 more seconds. We're almost there. Time's up. Time's up. Alright. Set number 3. Set number 3. 1, 2, 3 and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and of course 12. Well done, well done. Your rest period starts now. Your rest period starts now. So we'll still be sitting on this chair. I can even put it in this angle still. I can still put it in this angle. And we're going to do hammer curls using our water bottles, but we're going to do seated hammer curls. The beauty about sitting while you're doing curls is that the motion is a bit limited. So if you've been using momentum for that, in this episode, we're just gonna sit down and try and remain still. Our time's up. So I'm going to show you exactly what a hammer curl is. I'm going to show you what a hammer curl is. A hammer curl is down that way. 1, 2. All right. So we are going to do 12 times 3. 12 times 3. Using our water bottle. Using our water bottles. So if you can't get water bottles like mine, because mine are convenient and they have handles, you can get one, something that you can use
maybe a smaller water bottle, but now do more repetitions, okay? It's still okay. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, and move. 1. Let's move body momentum. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and of course one more, 12. Now in between we are going to do seated dumbbell press or seated press, military press. Because we don't have a dumbbell, we're gonna use water. Oh my goodness, let me secure this lead better. There we go, so let's go. 1, 2,
15 of them. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course one more, 15. Well done. Let me put our rest timer. Starting now, we have 30 seconds of rest. 30 seconds of rest, starting now. 30 seconds of rest. Make sure you drink some water. Always hydrate, it's been good for your skin. So hydrate as much as you possibly can. During this season, it's a bit cold, so there's a likelihood of you not taking enough water. So just make sure during your workout, you keep on sipping that water so that you increase your water intake and make it a deliberate effort. Our time's up. We're going in for the next set. Next set, we are starting with the hammer curls, then the dumbbell press. All right. 1, 2, 3, and move. 1. Slow and controlled. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and of course 12. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, and move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course 15. Well done. Your rest time starts now. The rest time starts now. Oh my goodness, I'm loving that I'm starting to feel the shoulders, feel the arms, you know. And to all those ladies who've been asking what is the secret to Michelle Obama arms, yo, this is the time to do it. All right, because we are rocking those upper body, that upper body. We have 5 more seconds to go. Our time's up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, and move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and one more, 12. Well done. All right, we are going for the dumbbell press. 1, 2, 3, move. 1, 2, 3, 4,
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and of course, 15. Well done, well done. You did well with the water bottles. Our rest time starts now. Our rest time starts now. Walk around, we have 30 seconds. Then we go for the 1 minute burnout. So, I want to challenge you to this. We'll hold our hands here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Up to 60. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Up to 60. It's like our burnout. Like we're just burning those shoulders down. All right. So, our time's up. So let's go. 1, 2, 3, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 30. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 60. Well done. We have one more set of that. Starting now. All right. We have 20 seconds of rest. So we have one more set of burnout. I hope you are able to hold your arm up. We are almost getting done with this episode and you have done amazing with your upper body. All right, so we have 1 second left and time's up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 30. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 50. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 60. Well done. That was it from us here on Cheesy New Bunny. You did so amazing. Started your day on a new normal, new energy. Until our next episode, have a lovely day. I was your host, Evelyn Noala of Evolve Health and Fitness. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and on Facebook. Have a lovely, lovely day.
Pata 50% extra credit off bila expiry. Ya kupiga na ku SMS across networks. Piga *444* scratch card pin hash. Na kama ni M-Pesa *444*2# Safaricom for you.
Now, the number of people in a church service has also been limited to 100 people per service, in which case, inamaanisha church zitaanza kukua na makanga.
Wapedwa wawili kaede. Wawiri service yanze.
Ni play bite yako kwa show ukisema hizo signatures zimechorwa ng'ombe.
Yeah.
How?
Kuongea ukweli ni ya gari ya list yake.
Yes. yenye my MPs walikuwa wamesign.
Yes.
Nikaona signature moja ilikuwa imechorwa kamera. Mimi nikafikiria pengine aliota akiwa jichopevu.
Ouch!
Ingine kuona ni Junet alikuwa amesign nikajua ni ngombe.
Akili, 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 akili. Let's just say germs away. Let's chase the germs away. By keeping our hands clean. And when you want to sneeze or when you want to cough, do it in your elbow. Let's practice sneezing into your elbow. Are you ready? One, two, three. Achoo! Again, achoo! Yay! You did it! Germs, germs, germs.
Pishi Home Chef is looking for the best home chef. Are you amazing at cooking that ugali, choma in that nyama, or can you bake that cake that keeps your neighbor awake? Show us your skills in the kitchen by recording a short video or taking a picture of your best dish or post it on any social media using the hashtag Pishi Home Chef. Then tune in to Your World on NTV from 7 a.m. every Friday to discover if you are this week's Pishi Home Chef. Go to pishi.co.ke for more details. This is NTV.
Hello and welcome to Your World this Friday, the 10th day of July. Now, although we still haven't reached the peak of infections in Kenya, and perhaps the worst might not yet be over, we thought we'd take a moment today to celebrate people who have gone out of their way to help their fellow Kenyans cope with the pandemic. Good morning. My name is Joseph Warungu, and coming up, today, we focus on stories of Good Samaritans as you tell us about your heroes during this coronavirus pandemic. A beautiful spectacle as artists' portraits of healthcare workers are displayed on Paris Bastille Opera House.
I've been using a mask for my colleagues.
Worried over the huge number of locals not wearing face masks, Victoria Namunyak, locally known as Model Officer, resolved to start sewing the masks to help curb the spread of the coronavirus.
See what you can.
A donkey randomly surprises webinar participants. In return, people get to donate to its farm. We'll be right back. Now, as we celebrate COVID heroes, call us or send us a video telling us who is your COVID hero and why. But first, let's look at the global numbers in terms of the coronavirus infections around the world. As at this moment, 12,387,826 people have been confirmed positive for COVID-19 around the globe. And of this, 7,187,447 have recovered from the disease, while 557,405 people have so far passed on due to the coronavirus disease. Here in Kenya, our numbers as at this moment, this is 8,975 people confirmed positive for COVID-19. 2,657 have so far recovered. 173 have passed on, unfortunately, here in Kenya. Across our East African region, in Somalia, this is the data, 3,038 people confirmed positive. 1,209 have recovered. 92 people in Somalia have so far passed on as a result of COVID-19. In Uganda, there is 1,000 people so far who have been confirmed positive. 908 have recovered, while no one so far, fortunately, is reported to have died in Uganda. In Tanzania, these numbers have not changed one bit for nearly 3 months. 509 positive so far, 183 recovered, and 21 people who have died in Tanzania as at the last time that the country filed its statistics. Rwanda, this is the situation. 1,210 people confirmed positive for COVID-19. 623 have recovered. 3 people have so far passed on. In Burundi, again, these are their numbers. 191 people confirmed positive. 118 have so far recovered. 1 person is reported to have died as a result of COVID-19. And this morning, let's look at the country in Africa that's leading in terms of cases. And that's South Africa. 238,339 people so far confirmed positive for COVID-19. 113,061 people in South Africa have so far recovered. And in that country, they've lost 3,720 people as a result of COVID-19. That's a country that's with the highest numbers in terms of COVID-19 infections around Africa. So that's the situation in East Africa and in our own country, Kenya. Now, could it be that the government rushed into declaring the 2020 education calendar year lost before exhausting all of the options? Well, the Kenya Private Schools Association is in total disagreement with the Ministry of Education on the matter, warning that the decision will have adverse effects on the curriculum. NTV's Seth Olale reports that the decision to declare 2020 a lost year could sound the death knell for some privately owned education institutions.
The 2020 academic year is lost, at least according to the government. And now stakeholders are beginning to come to terms with the possible consequences, one of them being a curriculum crisis.
How is it that surely with all the technicals we have, we couldn't figure out a way to transition our children? We can do KCPE. You don't have to test Vitus and the October. We had learned up to March. We can open for a few weeks and you tell us now we need this done. After all, it is a transition exam. It is simply used for placement.
The private sector says learning would not have been adversely disrupted by COVID-19 if the Ministry of Education had fully adopted e-learning.
Throughout the whole process of trying to get on board our schools onto the digital learning program,
yes,
the devices were coming in too expensive. Like the JKU Art ones were at 25,000,
yes,
a device, a tablet. You know, 20,000, 25,000.
Mm.
What Corona has taught us is that this online learning can happen on any device.
Private learning institutions have taken a big hit financially following the suspension of learning due to the pandemic and now many risk closure.
Private learning institutions have been struggling to get additional funding by providing online courses. But the model, they're saying it's too expensive and not sustainable. They now want the government to come in and help the sector that now is threatened with imminent closure due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
What is happening is breaches of contract. So if you have a 10-year lease, and then because you can't agree with the landlord, you breach that lease,
yes,
that college could still well continue at another venue.
Okay.
Yeah, so we don't quite have a clear, precise indicator. And I truly do hope that we don't lose any institutions, though I know one or two that are looking for
buyers. There are currently 288,000 teaching and unteaching staff. The country's education sector has 10,400 private primary schools hosting 2.14 million pupils. The number of private secondary schools is 1,627, with a capacity of 271,618 students. The total number of students in private primary and secondary schools is 2.4 million. Seth Olale, NTV.
Okay, so again this morning we asked you to tell us who you think is your COVID hero during this COVID-19 season. It's not yet over, but who so far has impressed you in terms of how they've gone out of their way to help their fellow Kenyans? And these are some of your comments. Yes, we asked you who is your hero and why. We have Meg Nyawira, who says, my parents and siblings for calling me all the time. Yes, thank you for keeping in touch. We also have Modoi G. Modoi. Myself for managing to wear a face mask with my windbreaker ears. Thank you, Modoi. And Kiama Wamuturi, you say, my hero is the medical lab technologist. He works behind the scenes to analyze samples and reports to the doctors, and no recognition is given. Thank you very much, Kiama, for that. Yasmin Ian Monday, you say, Achal Zablon, much appreciation. You gave me shelter for months after stumbling in my life. God bless you. Thank you, Yasmin. More comments. This one from Anthony Kaibuba. You say, my Nasami is a selfless young man who toils all day with a handcart and donates to the vulnerable. Asante, Anthony. And another hero here from Lillian Kengere. You say, definitely my father who is above. I thank him. We're all still alive and kicking despite the corona. He still reigns. He reigns indeed. And this one is Sarah Barori. You say, everyone that has survived this far. Yes, you recognize them as heroes and survivors. Kevin Olare, you say, my mom and dad, since I lost my job, they have been very supportive. So those are your COVID heroes. Asante. Jackilu, you say, one person by the name Elijah Samuel, who has been educating us and updating us about COVID-19. Thanks for that. And we also have Luere Ethan Paul, Magufuli of Tanzania. He has not put useless restrictions to his people in the guise of COVID-19. Haya, tumekusikia. And another comment here from Lillian Okwaro, my mom, who ensures that I have enough food to take me throughout the month. Thank you, Lillian. And this one is from Fred Lumumba. You say, your hero is Mutahi Kagwe for teaching me how to treat COVID abnormally. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Keep those comments coming in. We still want to know who is your hero, your COVID hero during this pandemic and why. And also send us your video if you can. Our hashtag is New Normal. Now, an officer based at the Isiolo JK prison warmed the hearts of many residents for using her free time to produce free masks for the vulnerable as part of her contribution towards the fight against COVID-19. Okay.
I am Victoria Lenarope. I work with Kenya Prison Service in Isiolo County. Nilikuwa nataka kukua fashion designer, ndo maana nikanunua hii sherani, lakini sikujua kama baadaye itasaidia community yangu. Ndio maana after curfew, during the day, instead of me kulala, natengeneza mask for my colleagues, hasa wale wenye wako curfew na mimi, na watengenezea mask. lakini saizi nimeamua kutengenezea community yangu kwa maana they are in danger too. Mimi nilijitolea kutoa from my own salary, nikajitolea kutengeneza hii face mask, nikaenda kutafuta hizi material from town na niliuziwa as cheap price. Niko na aim ya kutengeneza 5,000 with the help of some colleagues here and my best friends. We want you all to observe social distance, osha mikono na usanitize so that we will overcome this coronavirus.
So that's one of our heroes this morning, people who've gone out of their way to assist their fellow citizens during this difficult season. So we'll be speaking to her in a moment, but other guests will be joining me this morning to discuss this issue. We have Musa Otieno, who is the former Harambee Stars captain. We've got Michael Munene, a landlord in Kinangop, who made an amazing decision. We'll hear about that in a moment. We'll also be hearing from Yoga Heart Kenya. And we also have Vicky Namunyak, whose video you are just watching shortly. We'll also be joined by our colleague and reporter Seth Olale, who is NTV's senior reporter, to tell us what he's seen as he's gone into some of these isolation wards to see people who are also giving their time and risking their lives to save lives. Also, Eric Isinta, NTV videographer, is joining us for this conversation a little bit later. But first, let me go to Vicky Namunyak. Good morning and welcome to Your World.
Good morning too, thank you.
So Vicky, first of all, tell us, what do you do? What is your job?
I'm a prison officer stationed at Isiolo County.
Okay, Sasa, as a prison officer, why did you decide to help people with masks?
Okay, first of all is to prevent this contacting this coronavirus. And also I know some people are not in position to avoid, some are not, yeah, they are not in position to avoid. So I sacrifice my own salary to create such, to make those masks, face masks.
Na sasa ulipoanza kutengeneza hizi masks, watu walizipokea kwa njia gani?
Walifurahia, walianza kuona umuhimu ya kuwea mask kwa sababu mostly they assume it as hakuna coronavirus, lakini since mimi nimejitolea, hata pia wakaanza kujitolea, wakaanza kuosha mkono na pia kufuatilia those precautions.
Na sasa Vicky, umesema umetumia pesa zako kuwasaidia watu na hizi masks ama barakoa. Kuna watu wamejitokeza kuja kusaidia wewe mwenyewe?
Bado, lakini najua watakuja.
Asante. Sasa Vicky, yes. People have named you as a COVID hero kwa sababu ya kujitolea kuwasaidia katika wakati huu mgumu. How do you feel about that recognition from your fellow citizens?
Na appreciate sana na nawahimiza Wakenya wenzangu to act as an example to others so that we will overcome this coronavirus if we work in unity.
Sasa Vicky, watu wakikuangalia wanaona wewe ni askari gereza, wanakuona pia wewe ni mtu ambaye umejitolea kuwasaidia wananchi, na pia hapo nyuma ulikuwa model. Ni nini katika roho yako inakupelekea kuwasaidia watu na kufanya kazi zote hizi?
Okay, ikuanza saizi, wakati nilikuwa child, since childhood nilikuwa kwa children, helping children. Tulikuwa tukisanya pesa, tunapeleka kwa those orphanage children and also kuvisit those people at the hospital, tunawapelekea fruits. So kusaidia kwangu haijaanza saizi. So
na sasa Vicky, watu eneo hilo hasa pengine Isiolo, are they able to afford masks and sanitizers and things like that, kujikinga?
Okay, majority no, because penye nilipeleka majority are poor, they can't afford sometimes. Yeah,
haya, asante Vicky, stay on the line. Nakuja kwako tena. Musa Otieno, good morning, welcome to your world.
Morning, how are you?
Very well. Now, Musa, we've been following your story. Can we first of all clarify one thing? Were you actually tested positive for COVID-19?
Yes, of course. I'm even isolated in the house. I tested COVID-19 corona positive. That was 10 days ago. I was admitted in the hospital. I came back on the 5th. And now I'm 14-day self-quarantine in the house.
What was the experience? How did you actually, get infected? How did you get to find out?
I think for me, I'm having an organization called Kickoff to Hope, which I'm trying to help my community. But I can tell you that siwezi kuambia nilipata wapi, but nimesaidia wengi because of this pandemic. We have already helped like 1,000 families because the Gianni situation is a very difficult situation. But I think ukiangalia on the last week, nilianza kufeel some pain kwa chest, kubreathe ilikuwa bit of a challenge. Nilikuwa na fever, nilikuwa na feel weak. So I just took myself to Mbagathi Hospital because nilikuwa na feel ilikuwa ni abnormal kwa sababu I was waking up early in the morning because we had a session with the women at my community, which we call it Women Morning Women Fitness for Christ. I think for them, because at least wataka pia kwa fit kidogo, nikaona what can I do with the community, because unapata wachezaji niko nao, pia tulikuwa tunawasaidia na food, but women walikuwa mekani kama wako yani wako neglected. So through the organization nikasema okay, with this pandemic let's be fit pia. Nikakuwa tunaenda early in the morning, tumesaidia around 1,000 families in Maringo. Najua through food, najua there's some people will come in and can support. But then nikuambia last week I start feeling some awkwardness on myself because kubreathe ilikuwa ni shida. Fever, nikakuwa na high fever. Nika took to myself to Mbagathi Hospital. Kwenda hapo nikapimwa, wakaniambia nikuje after 4 days, which was a bit of a challenge because vile nilikuwa na feel, there's no way I could have gone back home. Tena nikajichukua nikajipeleka Kenyatta. Again, Kenyatta, the challenges ile tulipata hapo na the good things, ilikuwa lazima nitafute file kwanza. Nilistay another 1 hour ndio nipate file, niandikiwe, niadmitiwe. Nikapelekwa ward 7. I think hapo at ward 7 ndio nilisema there is somebody came in, Professor Kenyatta. When he saw me there, I was a bit of, wow, this is Musa Otieno kwa mali wapi hapa. Naona, ndio aka intervene. Nikakuwa, at least attention nikakuja very high hapo Kenyatta. Nikatoka hapo ndio nikapelekwa ward 42 nilika huko for 10 days, which naweza kuambia corona is real. Nilikuwa in another world, a world where siwezi tembea, a world where naweza taka kukula siwezi kula, na nikasema why, what is happening? But vile nakaa hivi na thank God, because it was not easy for me for those for the last 10 days.
Sasa coach, wewe background yako ni mtu ambaye you normally keep fit, umekuwa katika mazoezi, umekuwa ni mchezaji na nini, so haya maradhi, what was the effect? Ingawaje pia pengine mwili wako una nguvu, lakini bado yalikutisha kidogo.
I think nafikiria mimi kwanza mazoezi pia ilisaidia sana, kwa sababu one of the things nafikiria pia mimi ni kama nilikuwa naanza tizi asubuhi, but warm up ni kwa siku pia najiweka warm sana. Nilikuwa naanza dakika 10 nimevaa viwarm, and then kidogo nikishapata niko naona na sweat natoa muona. So first unapata chest ndio ilikuwa ni kama nilikuwa pneumonia. Chest ilipiga iko siwezi breathe. Oxygen ilikuwa sina hata kidogo. So I think the fitness pia mimi ilinisaidia sana, because nilipoenda pale nilika 10 days na vile nimetoka, I think fitness ilinisaidia, because there some people nilikuwa naangalia hapo ndani, maybe age tu ni yangu sawa, but naweza sema fitness pia mimi ilinisaidia, na the nurses wale walikuwa pale people wale walikuwa wananiprayia, but I can tell you it's not a good place to be. Okay. That is what I think I've been given a second chance to preach it, to kuambia watu jamaa, corona is real. What lazima wajichunge vile ministry inataka. Najua the nurses, the people have been praying for me. I think mimi na thank God, because kama si God, siwezi kuwa niko hapa sahi kuambia corona is real. Guys, let's follow the Ministry of Education vile nataka, governor nataka aje, because watu bado wanapuuza. Because watu wanapuuza kwa sababu maybe hajakushika, maybe hajashika ule mtu unajua. But as a fitness person, and yeah, those are the hardest time in my life. Naweza sema, guys, we mustn't play around. Corona is real.
Na sasa coach, zile picha na video tumeziona kuhusu wewe kwa WhatsApp na wapi, tumekuona kwenye machine unaongezewa oxygen. How long were you in those machines?
I think for me, ukiangalia yangu, haikuwa vile very difficult sana, but oxygen ilikuwa. Naweza kuambia for the first 2 days, hata kwenda kwa loo ilikuwa ni shida, because nilikuwa na struggle to breathe. So oxygen ilikuwa napewa natoa na nawekewa kwa sababu inafaifikia 92, 93, 94 hapo. Ilikuwa na toto maybe for 20 minutes, 30 minutes, na jaribu pata my own oxygen. But naweza kuambia, at a step to make, it was difficult. Najua the first few days hata kwenda, naweza kuambia kwenda kwa choo ilikuwa ni, yani this is somebody who has been trained, na kuambia ni experience, siwezi taka kuona mtu yuko ama mtu ana neglect kwa sababu ati anaambua don't do this, do that. Because I can tell you, it was difficult. It was very difficult in, unajua, kwa life yangu, enye hapo nilistuliwa.
Na sasa coach, before ukupata haya maradhi, what was your view of corona before yakupate?
I think nilikuwa tu vile nasema ati niza shika, hii si kitu ya watu wa mtaa. Unajua watu wa mtaa wanasema, wewe mtu wa tizi, unajua una neglect, leo tunapuuza. Kwa sababu ujo, kuna ile tabia tuko nao kama Kenyans, unasema, mimi hawezi nishika, unaona nani amekushika na corona? Unaona hiyo perspective niko nayo. Nilikuwa najua, but nilikuwa najua hizi ni za wangoso, hizi ni za watu wako Italy, mtu kama Musa ama mtu uko mtaa, because sijaona mtu around mimi. Ukitembea mtaa unaona watu wavai barakoa, yani watu wako tu pamoja, yani design, watu wacheza tu ball, yani watu wajali. Unaona, until yenyewe tusaliko na mtu anaziko anasema sitaki kuziko hivyo. But mimi nitakwambia, that Friday the 26th nilipoenda Mbagathi, I was in a totally different world. A world where there are some friends from Kiangalia, mtu kama Ubangola, alipiga simu, wajua mheshimiwa Mbatia, MCA, they were my family. Nilikuwa jua liko imewaka, nilikuja saa 2 kupimwa, nilipimwa saa 6. Na yani, siwezi kupatia that experience. Nikiangalia hivi, I thank to God, kwa sababu I think niko na testimony ya kutell Kenyans, guys, it is real. Kama Musa alipitia hapo, let's be serious.
And how long did it take kupata results?
For me, well, that is the challenge ilikumba kwanza. Because when I went to Mbagathi, waliponi pima wakaniambia nikuje after 4 days. But vile nilikuwa na feel, I'm the one who took myself, my family, nikajipeleka Kenyatta. So I was like, the symptoms nilikuwa nazo, already tried the nurses ama daktari wale kwa KNH, walifanya very wonderful job, because vile nilikuwa nawaambia, already walikuwa washajua, this is danger hapa. So results zangu zikuja after 3 days, kama niko ICU hapo Kenyatta.
Ulipopata results, what was your reaction?
Wajua, kuna one thing kwanza nikienda kupimwa, ilikuwa ni only 2 things. Ni either niko nayo ama sina. Kama niko nayo, stigma sasa. Unaona, family yangu itaiko kwa aje, mafriends wangu itaiko kwa aje, wale tunikuwa na trainer wako aje. Nilipopata results, mimi nilikuwa nataka tukupona. Because nilipoambua ni sawa, already nilikuwa najua sasa niko kwa the hands of God na ma nurses na doctor wa Kenyatta. Unaona? So hizo zingine mimi nilikuwa nataka tu kuangalia vile zatoka kwa hiyo ward. Because there some people walikuwa kwa ward nikiwaangalia, yani naona hapana. Yani kuna stories outside there in those wards, in those hospitals. Na tutu lazima tutu wa prayer, because naweza kuambia people are crying, people are feeling bad. Ujua mtu hawezi breathe, mtu ana cohort designing, una feel, ay apana.
Sasa coach, what kept you going?
For me, father, I think it's the faith. Na prayer zile enye, naweza sema to all my supporters, unajua, because I think God amenipatia second chance. A second chance ile nilipatia that talent, whatever I was doing with the corona, unajua supporting families na whatever. I think maybe amenirudisha back kuniambia, Musa, can you just, we have not finished your job. Job yako ni kwenda kuambia jamaa, this is real. You need to preach to the people. You need to be an ambassador to tell people that, you know what, guys, there is still God, because kama si God acha nikwambie kweli, mtu akikuwa na boost akisema ni yeye. But through the faith of God na prayers to my supporters, each and everyone who saw the video, I think ili niweka strong hata wale watoto niko na support ama hata my community.
Yes.
Unajua prayers is powerful.
Okay, na sasa yeah. Coach, what about your family? Are they safe?
Yeah, my family are safe. You know, they're in the house, they're safe. Na everybody who's closer to me is safe. Well, the good thing unapata pia kuna kila mtu alienda kapimwa, wakapatikana wako negative. So that is a big plus for me, even with the organization. Najua nikiangalia mtaa na feel, wow. Yani, I still have a big story to tell them. Yani ladies, watu wache mchezo.
Sawa. Na sasa, you've been nominated as a COVID hero because of your job ya kusaidia watu mitaani na nini. Tell us about what you've been doing in this very difficult season for the community.
I think first of all, niko na organization ajita Kick Off to Hope. Ilianza hapo Dr. Kraft Maringo. I think I use the tool of football to preach the gospel. Unapata tuka adopt a school which is called the primary school, which is called Dr. Kraft Primary School. Hiyo ndio shule nilikuwa nimeenda. That was my community. Niliporudi, nikaona what can I do with what God has given to me, and that is a talent. So nikasema hii ball yangu, wacha niangalie nini za saidia, because ukiangalia Dr. Kraft ya Maringo, so many international players wametoka hiyo mtaa. Na ilifika inajita Islando, ilifika mahali kakuwa tuko neglected. Because when you look at somebody like George Wawero, Musa Utieno, you know, chairman, the current chairman of FC Leopards, Dan Shikanda, you know, Chemtai, Helen Chemtai wa hockey, unajua, yani so many players wametoka hapo, but tunafika gamali, watu watake kurudi mahali walitoka. I'm not staying there, but to come back and give them hope. Na tukaona pia watu hiyo waendi church. Nini tunaweza fanya, tuka preach the gospel kwa watoto. Tunaweza chupa ball, because wanapenda ball. So what Dr. Kraft, nikuja tuka adopt Dr. Kraft, tume repaint, refurbish Dr. Kraft yote. Hata with this COVID situation, tuko tumwekea 10,000 liter tank ya maji. Nope. Najua sangi watoka all out kuangalia, this is my community, this is what God has given to me. Niko na some friends, unaona. So sikia COVID ilipotokea, corona, nika reach to my friends, tukakuwa na program na jita a supporter family. Nitasema mtu kama Carol Radul, that is somebody who she has been there for me, ku support families. At the moment, tunapata tukotisha support around 1,000 families, kupata tu a packet of food. Unaona. At least because our players walikuwa wanacheza, so zile wanacheza tulikuwa tunawataka, but after the difficult times, what are they doing at home? Tukasema tunaweza jaribu tu kuwekea a food on their table for the community to be healthy. Mtu yeye acheza ball kama yuko healthy. Okay. So through the friends all may come in, Mheshimiwa MC Mbatia. Friends have been coming in, my friends from Kamtoyoyo, those are players which I played with in the US, while come in waka support. So hiyo kati ya kusupport ndio pia ukakuja ukapata this situation. Unaona, because imekuwa kwa watu, and then all of a sudden wote wamepatikana, hey, una support alafu tena kwa hivi.
Okay.
Again, ukiangalia through their prayers, niko, yeah.
Sawa, tutaendelea ni conversation, lakini just before ni pause kidogo. So at the moment, are you fit? Unaweza kupiga first half ya ball?
First half?
Yeah.
Hey, at the moment, nako first half ni noma, lakini naweza kupiga passes mbili tatu, zile ulizaji wa kweli, uchali bado yuko.
Bado yuko.
Yeah.
Sawa, basi, just hold on, wacha tutaongea kidogo, subiri hapo hapo. Okay.
All right. Thank you
so much, Musa. Stay on the line for us. Now I'm joined by a caller. Irongo, good morning. Welcome to your world.
Good morning to you.
Hello, Irongo, good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Good morning.
Good morning. Now you've nominated your brother as a COVID hero. Tell us why.
Yes, because this brother of mine has been a real friend to me. He has been a brother, and he has been helping me in very many ways. So when I'm in a problem or when I'm in need, he is one who comes out to at least help a brother, and I felt it is a good season I should celebrate him, because he has been supporting me, and unceasingly, he doesn't resist when I request him to.
Okay, now, Irongo, I believe your brother can hear you. What do you want to say to him?
Brother, I want to tell you here today that you have been a very special person to me. I know I have some other siblings, but I want to tell you that you are special in your own way. I don't want to say that I don't love the others, but you stand more stronger for me. And I want to say that God gave me a good brother in you. May God continue blessing you. And I want to appreciate you this morning on NTV.
Asante Rungu. John, good morning. What's your reaction to this nomination from your own brother?
Wow, it's a little surprising. And I just want to thank God for everything and also for him.
Okay. How have you been supporting him, John, briefly?
Maybe, you know, as a brother, and when he calls, sometimes there is nothing else you can do that, but just to help with the little that you have, and also to encourage him, and also especially during this time where everybody needs to be, you know, encouraged and also assisted in whichever way one can see or can deem fit.
Okay, well, John, thank you very much indeed, and also Irungu for joining us this morning. And if you're watching, who is your COVID hero and why? Let us know. You can call us up, you can send us a video, you can send us comments on our hashtag New Normal. Now, Vicky, bado upo, let me come back to you kidogo.
Yes.
Sasa, watu wa Isiolo, how are they coping? How are they coping na hii hali ya corona?
Saizi wameanza ku adapt, wakaanza kujua COVID is real. Sasa naona wanatimiza hizo precaution yenye iliwekwa. Wanaanza kuweka social distance. Pia nilivisit penye nilipeana mask. Naona wanafuatilia sana hizo precautions.
Na bado masks zinahitajika? Bado kuna watu wanahitaji masks?
Ndio. Haswa kwa places yenye iko crowded, kama hizo soko zenye wanauzanga matunda, hizo naona kama zinahitajika sana sana.
Kwa hivyo sasa ungetaka kuomba msaada wa aina gani? Ni nini ambacho pengine bado ni challenge kwako?
Okay. Mimi nataka sana ni fund kidogo, ndio ni raise kidogo hiyo amount ya nini, pia watu wajitolee washone, wanitumanishie ndio tuendanishe pamoja tuwapelekee, kwa sababu mimi peke yangu sidhani kantaweza.
Okay, na sasa unapotembea mjini hapo Isiolo, watu wanakutambua, wanakuambia nini?
Sasa juu nimeanza kukua public figure, wananiambia kila siku. Sasa hata nikienda shughuli yangu wananiambia, Viki, wapi mask. Sasa hiyo ndio changamoto na face sana. Sasa inabidingi lazima nibebe kaa 10-20 ndio nikienda nikipatana nao nawapea nikirudi nyumbani.
Haya, asante Viki, subiri kidogo, tunarudi tena kwako. Musa, let me come back to you again briefly.
Yeah.
Sasa, what are the challenges that you're facing in terms of your project here, giving out food packets to people who really need it?
I think the challenge is that you know, most of the donors or maybe of the friends who are coming in to support, nafikiria zina toka tu from my individual friends which have been coming in because they're still needy. You are each and every one of the player inside, because wachezaji wengi pia wanasuffer down there in the grassroots level, because unapata through your friends with your PM to moja always this idea the whole community. But challenges is the funding, which I think it is a bit of a challenge, because me nikiona nikienda pale when I support them na feel okay, but funding is a bit of a challenge. But again, pia God said me nipatie another opportunity ya kuenda kuzunguka kwao, kwa sababu I believe that it is a second chance ile nimepewa, because at least sometimes we're just looking at the government. But people like us who have situation like those ones, what can we go back and again send the message to our community, to our people? Because the president himself cannot do it alone. Is that true? But jikumu letu sisi wote na this idea. What can we do? Because down there still, what bado me neglect? Kwa mitaa, bado kuna ile design, mwajo ni aje, mi sijali. But on the food side, still a lot of families are in need. Najua mimi nasema tu, I still believe that nikitoka natoka niko very strong. I still want to continue with whatever I've been doing to help my community. Because when I grew up, I believe, I grew up in a community. Na as a believer, and I think this is what I'm doing for Christ. Now whatever I'm doing, I'm not doing for Musa. I think this is something which has sent me to do. And I believe I still have a job to do for him to glorify his kingdom.
Na sasa Musa, for these guys mtani ambao nasema wakati mwingine with corona nasema hawajali sana, what is the issue?
I think it's just a message. It's just a message ile mtu anasema haijanishika. Umeona, because kama mtu anasema, I think 10 days ago it was like ati Musa alishikwa na corona. Unajua ilikuwa ni a big story. I'm a human being too. I think that is somebody, people realize, hey, jamaa, this thing is real. Because watu wanasikia yako wanasema iko tuko Italy, kwa watu wanado, kuna watu wajua, oje isikia ati best yako ati ameshikwa na corona. Ati, imagine ati it was ati Musa Otieno ameshikwa na corona. It was a big thing. Unaona? So inakuambia, corona is there and it is real. So what message can we give to our community? What message can we give to our people? Down there, mali, maybe radio ifiki, maybe pengine mtu watacheza nao ball, mtu kwa weni coach. Tunajukumu. Mali, jukumu ni yangu, ni yako, ni mtu mwingine. But me, I believe, nikitoka hapa, natoka very strong. It is a campaign mili nataka kusema, nandafanya. I think spread the message clear because those people are there for me, only prayer. I was in that situation. Nimepewa another second chance. What can I do to help people to reach that your message wafikie?
Okay, sasa, coach, how soon before urudi tena uwanjani kwa ball?
At the moment, nimeshaka for 5 days in the house. Na hope again another 11 days self-isolation. And then from there, I go back to Mbagathi again, niangalia doc, wanambia what needs to be done. But I believe, niko na that eagerness of trying to educate people. Kuambia, hey, kama Musa Otieno aliipata, pia unaweza ipata. What are we supposed to be doing as a group or as a community? Because jukumu ni letu. You're my family, you're my friend. Na mimi believe friend ile mtu anakuambia kweli. This is wrong, this is right. Wajua, because it is expensive pia for some of the guys. What can they do to support each other? Me, God, amenipatia that opportunity, alinipeleka hapo, nimefeel, nimetoka, nimeprayer. What can I give back to you guys? Nikuambia, jamaa, Minister of Education, this is a precaution. This is what is happening. Nilifeel for the last 10 days, hosi. Sayi ni consolation in the house. Now, so many things are going through my head. Wala tuniluwacha pale pia, ni wasik. What are their family going through? Unaona? Unaona mtu wezi tembea, mtu wezi kula. Maybe because haku vaa mask. Maybe because haku that social distance ali had neglect. Maybe aliambosi yate mali kuko crowded. Unaona? But because nasema, haiku nishika. So, misi jali. I think nina job ya kufanya for Kenyans.
So, na sasa, coach, you mentioned umesaidika pia kidogo sababu ulikuwa ni mtu ambaye fitness yako ilikuwa iko juu. Sasa, the importance of kukaa fit in this season, what would you say about that?
I think because when take pia obesity inakuja, because people are just eating and relax, you can do a homework, work home training in the house. Because in the same fitness pia mili nisaidia. No, for the first 2-3 days ilikuwa a bit of a challenge because of that oxygen nilikuwa. Enye kama una oxygen, nilaweza kuambia, I didn't even come a step, ilikuwa a challenge. Kwenda kwa toilet, ilikuwa ni a challenge. Umeona? But with the fitness, we just need to be fit. Ni either tututumia pesa zetu kwa daktari, ama tututumia kwa fitness trainer. So where do you want to use our money?
Na na tips zako kwa mtu ambaye kwa mtaani hana do za fit, za instructor na nini, what are your tips za kubado kukifitu kiwapo hapo tu?
Kuna so many things kwa sababu ukiangalia equipment ziko mob around wewe. Unajua sometimes ni kuangalia what kind of equipment ziko. Kenda kwa YouTube utapata so many different training, but unapata mtu za trainer chupa na maji, umeka tu maji kwa chupa, ukaanza session zako. Si lazima kuna expensive equipment ati uta train. Unaweza piga squats kwa kiti, unaweza piga lunges kwa nyumba. Unaona? Unaweza training za biceps. You can just walk in the house around. At least you do something, hata kama ni 10 minutes, hata kama ni 15 minutes. At least for you to be healthy.
Okay. Musa, thank you. Stay on the line for us. And remember, as Musa is mentioning, the importance of staying fit. We're giving you free fitness instructions in the morning. You can join us every morning here on NTV, Monday to Friday from 6:30 a.m.
to 7 a.m. We give you a half-hour workout that you can do from the comfort of your home, led by our own professional fitness instructors who are also instructing from their houses. So join us from Monday to Friday, 6:30 to 7 a.m. And also remember, you can reach us by phone if you want to. You know, the phone lines, the numbers are at the bottom of your screen. This is how you can reach us. You can also send us a WhatsApp messages. We'd love to receive your videos. And also you can engage with us on our hashtag New Normal for comments, questions, even to the people who are sharing their experiences. Remember, this morning we're focusing on your COVID heroes. Who are the people in your view you feel have gone out of their way to assist their fellow Kenyans in this really difficult season, and tell us why you're nominating them. Now, Vicky, let me come back to you briefly. So are you still, in terms of producing masks, how many are you able to produce now?
Okay, so far I have contributed 1,000. The other time I contributed to 500. So, but I have I aim our targets for at least even 5,000, God willing.
And how many, in terms of the people who need these masks, are there still a lot of people who are in need of help for masks?
Yeah, for instance, there at home, I am from Marsabit County in Laisami sub-county. My people there are illiterate. So not even affording, but even giving them precautions, it is a lot of task. So I think they are in need always, yeah.
Now, Sasa Vicky, you're a full-time prisons officer. Where do you get the time to produce masks and to distribute the masks?
Okay, after my own duty, after free time, a sacrifice after doing my general duty at her house, then I sacrifice 3 hours, I guess. Then I do sewing.
Okay, and the people, your bosses, are they supportive of what you're doing?
Yes, they are encouraging me to do so because charity starts as you.
Okay. Asante sana. We hope that people who are watching this will also be able to come to your assistance to help you reach your target of 5,000 masks for the people in that part of our country who are in need of help. Musa, nije kwako tena kidogo. Sasa, Gava imetuambia mko huru kutembea through the counties. This thing is in your hands, sasa mjipange. What is your message to watu ambao wanaangalia wanasema mse hii kitu haiko
vile tupatie vile gavana alitufungulia? I think waliangalia so many angles na walitupatia pia precautions za kutuambia mko huru, but vile niko nasema lazima ujiangalie. Unajua ukiangalia mahali watu wako crowded, you're not supposed to be there. Ni wewe mwenyewe inaanza na wewe, because ukiangalia unataka kuingia kwa matatu na hakuna sanitizers, unaingia kufanya nini? Ukiangalia mahali watu wako crowded, unajua, so inafai ianze na sisi as a person, kwa sababu gava they have done their part. Ni either sasa wewe jukumu liko kwako, wala tunapenda tunasema kama napenda familia yangu, to try as much as we can as human beings, why can't we just try and do the right thing? Tumekuwa na neglect kusema unajua, niaje kila siku tunaona kila mtu anasema Minister of Health ana ni time ya Mutai kagwa kutangaza, kila mtu anataka kuona hiyo situation, but saa zile itakujia wewe na familia yako ni a burden.
Lakini sasa challenge ni kwamba jamaa, do you hustle upate chakula ama ni uanze kukimbizana na mambo ya corona? Jamaa kwanza nitafuta survival.
Because kukula pia iko, but kwa kukula unaambiwa kama mtu ana mask na kuuzia, why should you buy from how him? Ona get, see zile vitu una decision unazojimekia. Because kuna zingine unaangalia, because okay, atujui eti mtu ametoa food wapi, but there's some things unaona ni kitu mbaya. So kama ni kitu mbaya, I don't need to do it. Because na your precaution later itakuwa ni danger kwangu, you know. So gava kutuambia au kutufungulia everything, sasa tuta to misuse ama tufanye hiki tunataka kudu, because tuliambiwa sasa kila mtu lazima ajitegemee mwenyewe, unaona. Hizo bills zitakuwa ziko wapi? I'm very lucky, ukiangalia nilipoenda bills gava alikuja amelipa na whatever, so nashukuru, but this time around what will happen, you know, ni itakuwa ni burden kwa familia au na do, But imagine umepelekwa mahali kwa private hospital for 10 days. Hiyo si ni familia yako umeleta chini. Utasema na gava saidia. Na gava alikuambia oshe mikono. Umeona? But hiyo message inafikaje huko chini? Unaona? Huko chini mahali yenyewe watu sasaenda mamita. People are playing hata kama ni ball. Watu wako pamoja, watu wako crowded. Napita hapa Kibira, watu wako crowded. Unaona?
Okay. Coach, yeah. Stay on the line for us. Asante sana as I take this caller from Baringo. Good morning and welcome to your world.
Yeah, how are you?
Very well, Amon. What would you like to say today?
I want just to say Musa is my hero, comic hero. Actually, he's a great friend of mine. We fellowship in the same church. I'm a pastor. And he has been a great, great, great inspiration to the people of Baringo.
Okay. Amon, I'm sure Musa can hear you. What would you like to say to him?
I would want to say that we truly love him, and we really appreciate the work that he does to us in Baringo. In fact, he came in handy because being a man that he was, a professional playing football outside Kenya, and then coming back and humbling himself to come back to the community, and just being a blessing and giving back to the community.
And so, Amon, you're from the area in Baringo, which has produced a lot of stars. Yeah. Are you positive that more people like Musa will come out to help the local community?
Very indeed. Many people from Baringo, they have come, they have really supported, and they are still willing to support him even after he went through what he went through. We actually went into our knees to pray for him because we really believe in what he does. He has taken many of our youth out of the streets.
Okay, and so now Amon, when it was announced or it was known that Musa had contracted COVID-19, what was the reaction?
Well, it was shocking. It was unbelievable because you couldn't believe such a person who was giving all that he was giving. And the knowledge and the you know, what we knew about the COVID, if you are fit, you are eating well, this thing is just going to be. But when we saw him on those ventilators, we really knew this thing is real.
Okay. Amon, yeah. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much indeed. I'm sure the coach amepokea hayo yote.
Asante
sana. Now, okay. Now, Seth Olale, who is our reporter here, spoke to a nurse at the Kenyatta National Hospital Infectious Disease Unit's intensive care unit just to get a sense of what it's like for a frontliner. The nurse is definitely a hero, but today we also appreciate our A-level team, Seth Olale, the reporter, and Eric Isinta, the videographer, who also, you know, took that risk to go and cover this kind of stories. But first, here's a story.
We are taking care of patients who have COVID-19 disease or who are suspected of COVID-19 disease. There's the fear of what if one gets infected? What if in the event of providing care for the patients, I also get infected? When we arrive, we change into the appropriate uniform, and then we take the patient's report, and then we plan for the patient's care as based on the report that we have.
Mama, honey.
Twice I have had a cough, and that was very scaring. I went for testing, and after a day I had the results, which tested negative, and that now allayed my fears. But obviously every time you have a symptom that is COVID-like, then you also get worried a bit. The initial phases were very low moments for my children especially. Because I remember one of the first weekends we had was after the news about the positive patient. Yes. Then all of us were fearful that we may have been infected.
Yes.
And so conversations were more of, just in case I get infected, then I'll have to go for isolation, quarantine, and that is something they had to start getting used to. I also had to let them know that in case I am away, then the family needs to run, and that is now a conversation with my husband. I'm married, and things need to go on as normal.
Have you ever lost a patient, unfortunately?
Well, sadly, yes. We have lost patients, and it is not a very good experience. When I am away from my workplace, I find time to unwind with the family, especially nature walk. I love nature.
Have you had successful recoveries?
Oh yes, I think the successful recoveries are many from our statistics. I'm not sure we can tell the end. What I'm sure of is COVID is here, and we all are doing our best in responding at different levels, for us as frontline health workers, but for the rest of the population, following the Ministry of Health guidelines, that is how we together can actually overcome COVID. Very important is my spiritual foundation. It lays the basis. I kind of have a guarantee that I am getting into caring for patients with COVID. Not alone, God is with me and with the team.
Okay, so the NTV team that covered that story are here with me in the studio. My colleague Seth Olale, who's a senior reporter. Good morning, welcome to Your World.
Good morning.
And we also have Eric Isinta. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, now let me start with you, Seth. Before you, what was going on through your mind before you entered that facility?
It was shocking. Sincerely, you know, I've never come close to COVID-19. And this is not just to create stigma or victimize even the pandemic itself, but just to, it became real for the first time in my life when I was just, you know, putting on the personal protective kit. It now dawned on me that, you know what, you're going to face COVID head on. Yeah, because we're told immediately we enter that ICU ward that COVID is in the air. And so I felt fear, I must admit, and I was like, you know, God for us all. This is a story that we've been pursuing for a very long time, and the opportunity has come. And so it was the only chance to tell the story. But at the same time, deep within me, I knew that anything would happen from that unit.
Now, that was the reaction, despite the fact that as a team, we had set Seth and a couple of other people aside as our crack team, that you are you will be the last team standing in case anything, God forbid, should happen to the team. You are the ones who have to go into those dangerous territories. Now, there are things that the camera cannot capture in terms of people's reactions. What sense, as a human being, not even as a journalist now, did you get walking through that ward, seeing all these people in those conditions?
I became so emotional when Eric and I, you know, just now went into the ICU unit, and the first room we entered, actually all the units, all the rooms were full of patients in dire help. And I became so emotional when we just entered that room 3, which had this 7-year-old boy, and the mother was also there. Yeah, both COVID-19 positive patients. And, you know, the hardest bit was when that boy was just looking at me, staring at me. He's on a ventilator, he can't talk to me. And you know what, I told the mom that he's gonna be okay. Our prayers as NTV are with the little boy. And yeah, because of confidentiality, of course, of the patients, I couldn't engage her much, but I just gave the mother some sort of, you know, relief and, you know, encouragement. But that was the hardest. That was quite a very emotional experience. Yep. And it just dawned to me that, you know, we view COVID as far-fetched, but this is a reality.
It's with us.
It is with us.
Okay. Isinta, I know your eye was on the camera throughout, but what was going through your mind as you walked through that facility?
Okay, I'm not laughing, but I imagine the situation in Kwapale, and it was really tense moment. At first, unajua mimi kwa nikienda hizi features za huko kushoot documentaries, huko kwenda Mabaringo nini, and then ama maybe during hizi attacks. So, umeshaletwa place au juu unapigana na nani? Yeah? Then unaambiwa ingie kwa ward. Kwanza wewe mwenyewe sijaingia kwanza ICU. That is the first time nimeingia kwa ICU. Alafu unapata unavaliwa zile hizo pipi zao maze, hizo vitu ziko na joto guy. Una sweat, then cameraman, we imagine kuona kamera kama hii kubwa, umeingia pale ndani umevaa zile, kuna hizo hizo makaa specs umevaa, alafu umefunikwa huku kwote, so una imagine, alafu umevalishwa gloves. Unajua cameraman most of the time lazima utumie vidole zako kufanya ma adjustment kwa kamera. So unapata vitu zingine utafanya. Actually kitu nilifanya kwanza, nilifanya mimi nishtuke sana ni wakati niliingia ndani, then kwa hiyo room pia ilikuwa dark, so lazima ningefungua tufungue mlango ndio tupate kupata light kidogo, ndio at least ya kufilm. So mimi nilipoingia pale kwanza uoni, sababu at first hizo specs zishaingia usha sweat, then akanika mist, so zina prevent usione kenye unaona kwa kamera. So hata kenye niko na shoot huko ndani most of the time sikuona, but mimi kitenye iliniuma, to be very fair, kenye corona iko, wacha sidanganyane, corona iko.
Before ingia kwa order ulikuwa unafikiriaje kuhusu corona before ingia kwa hiyo facility?
Mimi najua wenyewe, mimi ni wala nasema tu wacha tu ni confess wale madoting Thomas. Mimi niko kwa hiyo patego. Nilikuwa nasema hii corona my friend, kwa sababu nilikuwa tukienda hizo mabriefing za kagwe, unapata hizo namba zinaongezeka every time. So uko like eh, ikiyenye hii kitu ni ukweli? Ai, I love them, your friends wanakuuliza, wewe hebu tuambie ni unafanya karibu kwa TV, unafanya kwa TV, hebu tuambie kama kitu ni real. Mimi naona kama government kudanganya. So wakati niliingia pale ndani ndio nilipiga reality, nilipiga. Kwanza kuona huyo mtoto mdogo ako 7 years. Huyo kijana manze, aliniangalia kwa macho na nasema for like 30 seconds, sikuamini. Huyo mtoto aliniangalia straight kwa macho, nikashindwa hata, I think kama siku record actually. Nadhani hata nilipanic tu kwa sababu una imagine this small boy ajui story ya corona. Yeah, tu hata ajui kitu yote kuhusu corona by the way. So vile alipata, okay. It was so sad moment.
Na hali ya watu ya ugonjwa ilikuwaje? Watu walikuwa sijui katika na uchungu nini, hali ya ugonjwa generally ulionaje?
Wewe jaribu ku imagine ward iko na hiyo place ilikuwa na 8 rooms. Hizo zote ziko na watu wako na corona. Alafu kitu moja baadaye sijui kama Seth ali notice hapo nje ya hiyo place, hiyo building iko isolated na iko na 8 ilikuwa na 8 wards. Then kuna security walikuwa nje. So si place watu unaenda tu unaingia. Ni place hata kabla upite ukwenda huko naambiwa unaenda wapi huko kwa sasa infectious center. So uone imagine huko ndani vile mtu ana feel. Unajua kuna hizo video zikuwa zikienda around kwa TV about watu wakidance and wakifanya maybe ma doctors. Watu wana assume corona ni place, yaani ward ni place kuna raha. So watu wanaona hii corona ni kama iko, kiona vile watu wanafanya watu wana recover. So wanaona hii ugonjwa ni kama iko. But the moment unaingia kwa ile ICU ndio nyewe unajua reality iko. Unajabu ward unaza kaa kidogo kama vile Musa tena alisema, utaingia kidogo alafu uta recover kama immune yako iko poa, uta recover.
Okay.
But wewe una imagine sasa uko kwa ward ICU uko peke yako in that pain manze.
Haya. Eric, asante. Wiki hii tumekuchanganya, umekuwa katika ward ama facility ambayo hujaingia, umezoea kuwa nyuma ya kamera, sasa uko mbele ya kamera. Wiki hii sijui hali ikoje, lakini we'll take a short break. We'll continue with these conversations with this the NTV team that was in this isolation facility, and we'll be right back after this break.
ukiambiwa 1 plus 2 10 marks uweze andika 3.
Hebu fanya ujinga uvae jeans, t-shirt na kofia, uingie kwa gari makanga akuitishe fee umwambie nitakupea tukishuka. Unasikianga? Dondoa moja dere.
Wear your mask and maintain social distance always, and sneeze or cough into your elbow. Book your ticket online via iAbiri and use our cashless payment options to play your part to win the COVID-19 war.
Hey, as a professor, out of analytical observation, I have realized that there are three types of coughing. Kukohoa, kuna wale wa... Huu ni mtu wako na pesa. Account is loaded. Kuna hawa wa...
To get this Kiza tune, dial star 811 star 848 hash for Professor.
Kumbuka unapojilinda unawalinda wengine pia. Tuko pamoja kwa hili.
Njia halisi ya kuosha mikono. Jambo la kwanza, lazima utumie sabuni. Unachukua ile sabuni na kuhakikisha kwamba umeweka katika sehemu yote. Kisha unakuja katika sehemu hii ambayo inafanyika kama kiwiko. Na wanasayansi wanasema kwamba viini pia vinapatikana ndani ya kucha, na hivyo basi wanahimiza kucha ziwe fupi. Nakumbuka unapaswa kuosha mikono yako si mara moja kwa siku, mara kadhaa.
Partnership with the Ministry of Health, let's join together in following the set protocols. Wear your mask, sanitize, maintain social distance, and have your temperature checked each time you visit our stores. Naivas saves you money.
Good morning and welcome back to Your World. This morning, we're looking at COVID heroes. We asked you who in this season do you think has gone out of their way to assist their fellow citizens, their colleagues, their families and so on. Who would you nominate as your COVID hero and why? And on our panel this morning, we have Musa Otieno, a former captain of the Harambee Stars, our national team, who's with us, who himself has gone through that COVID positive experience. We also have Vicky Namunyak, who is a prisons officer in Isiolo, who has gone out of her way to make a lot of masks to distribute to people who cannot afford to buy masks. We also will be joined by Michael Monene, landlord from Kinangop, who went out of his way to, you know, show a lot of generosity to his tenants. And we also have my colleagues here, Seth Olale and Eric Isinta. This is the NTV team that went into the isolation facilities to really tell us a story of what it means to be infected with this coronavirus, and also what the medics on the front line have to go through. Vicky, so that I can let you go off to your duty, let me start with you. What would be, maybe even as I speak to you, I understand there is a caller who's just come on the line for you. Good morning. Good morning, Emma. Good
morning, how are you?
Hi, Emma, good morning. Can you hear me?
Good morning, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you for phoning in. What would you like to say?
I'm really impressed by Kenyans because they are always forthcoming, and I wish they could come the same way they come helping others for this COVID-19, because I feel like they are a bit careless. Nevertheless, I am really impressed by Wainaina. I saw him when he was featured at his Kinangop home. But I'm mostly impressed by Vicky because being an officer on duty, she has she dares do something that others have not even thought of. You know, my daughter is also an officer in the army, and they always have a lot of things to do. And for her to think of those people in Masterbase, I think we can really vote her in because Masterbase is not easy place to live in. It's not easy to get around with those people. I think she merits to be honored for that. And I'm ready to help her in any way that she would want me to help her.
Okay. Emma, Vicky can hear you. Vicky, what would you like to say to Emma?
I really appreciate. Thank you. May God bless you.
Thank you so much. He will bless you too because of the way you have gone for your people.
Okay, Emma, thank you. We'll share Vicky's contacts with you so that you can get in touch directly to see how best you can help her. She has a target of reaching 5,000 masks. So we'll put you in touch.
She will.
Asante. Thank you so much
for featuring them.
Thank you. Thank you, Emma.
Asante
sana. Okay. Haya. Vicky, asante sana, Vicky. Tumeshukuru kuongea nasi leo.
Okay.
Salimia watu wa Isiolo na pia watu wa Marsabit mkiongea na tunakutakia kila laheri. Bila shaka wa Kenya watajitokeza kukusaidia kwa kila njia kuhakikisha kwamba utaweza kwa uwezo wako huo mwenyewe kutengeneza ama kuzalisha hizo mask 5,000 ambazo ndatafuta. Asante sana kwa kuwa nasi asubuhi ya leo.
Thank you very much. May God bless you.
Okay, asante. Now, back to the studio with my colleague Seth Olale and Eric. So Eric, you went into that facility ukiona doubts kama hii corona kweli ni kitu ina exist. Ulipotoka, akili zako sasa zinakuambiaje kuhusiana na corona?
Unaona paka sasa hivi unaona hata siko comfortable, nilishtuka. Unajua kwanza ushapi wewe ulikuwa mentality yako ilikuwa najuanga from before hapo kitambo ulikuwa na corona. Sasa hii umeingia umeona. Kwanza ule mimi hata kwanza kitu inaniuma sana ni ule mtoto niliona pale 7-year-old. Huo sasa nilinifanya hata nika okay, roho yangu tu iliumia kwa sababu huu mtoto nilikuwa nasema from nilisema tu mapema, huu mtoto ajui kitu yote, ajui hata kama corona ina exist. Yeye tu aliliekwa pale na kuna mama yake ako helpless. Enyewe ilikuwa painful but nasema sasa hii naendelea tu kujiki busy at least kidogo ndio at least hiyo kitu itakuwa kwa akili.
Okay.
So, well, Eric, isn't it? You know, I'm watching Eric, how soft spoken he is before the camera and how he usually, you know, orders us around. Seth, on your left, on your right. But the new normal for Isinta, actually. And Isinta, my question to you is, you know, when you are told to, you know, sanitize that camera, and you are told that, you know, now we are going into a very critical environment, and now, you know, you need to, you know, get hold of that equipment and you need to wrap it up carefully. What was going into your mind? Because you are doing this maybe for the very first time and, you know, just making sure that the camera is not infected. What was going into your mind? Because you are going next to put on that PPE.
Said the first thing by the way came to my mind is, so am I going to be infected? Because camera yenyewe si ati kuna cover tumeiweka, so I had to request for the doctors to help me with the kuna ile polythene tukaifunika. But bado najiuliza swali, hii camera hata ukiingia pale ndani sasa ujui kama hii corona iko juu ya hewa ama, so kuna opening mingi sababu nilifunga ndio nusu, but ilikuwa lens huwezi funga sababu ndio natumia. So bado nilikuwa na ile tu uoga, unajiuliza kwani nimetumwa huku? Alafu najua hii assignment, tuseme tu kweli, mdosi wangu Juma, mimi nilikuwa leave. yani off, sorry, nikaitwa nikuja kufanya hii documentary. So nikajiuliza, eh, kwani ikuitwa hii assignment shwali ilikuwa tayari nikuja unajua ile unajishuku, kwa nini mimi nilichaguliwa kuja kufanya hii? Na all along nimekuwa nikitoroka kwa sababu parents pia unataka kuenda, si ati nikutoroka kutoka kwa job, but from parents sitaki kuwa visit sababu naogopa kuenda kuinfect. So saa hii nimetumwa kwanza pali corona iko. Sasa too much was happening in my head, but nilisema ni job na Mungu ni anajua skule utakuwa utaenda, so you only live once. So nikasema kama ni job ni job, but all in all wale doctors walikuwa wazuri, walinipea hiyo paper, walinitutu sanitize, nikaingia ndani nikapiga shughuli, na hiyo ndio uzuri moja, ukisiogope Mungu yuko.
Okay, now Seth and Eric as well, let's talk about the people who are on the front line of this campaign, the mm-hmm. COVID-19 campaign. You had first, you know, you had face-to-face meetings with them. Mm-hmm. You saw firsthand what they actually do. What would you say about those doctors, nurses, the medics who are looking after people who are sick?
Well, those young people, they are sacrificing a lot. Because like Eric said, we were in those PPEs for, I think, 30 minutes. And they usually put on those PPEs for about 4 hours each and every day, going inside there. Putting on that PPE is the most uncomfortable thing that can happen to you each and every day. It is so hot, you can barely breathe, yeah? But they have to endure that. Apart from that, they're putting their own lives at risk. But what I can say to them is, you know, when we were even engaging them before we went into the ICU wards, they just have some beacon of hope, you know, and they're so courageous and positive. And they tell you, Seth, you know, we have to be counted. We have to be counted. History has to judge us rightly. And what I can just say, when I look at those young faces I saw, you know, just making sure that, you know what, they're doing their best, they're positive towards, you know, making sure that the treatments work. And of course, they also told us they felt so bad, especially each and every moment when a patient, you know, yeah, dies. So what I would just say that they are real heroes on the front line.
Okay, Seth, thank you. We have a caller on the line, Bob. Bob, good morning. Welcome to your world.
Morning, sir. My name is Bob Ichwara.
Yes, Bob, welcome to the show. And what would you like to say?
My question is to Seth Olade.
Go ahead.
Yeah, and my question is this, or my comment is a concern of all Kenyans, yeah? That strongly we feel there are people who go out there to just act. It's like a movie. An example of the latest that has come out is about Bulale. He was in a cab and he was in his specs or shed, and he was recording himself, and then it was reported that he was in ICU. Apparently, that killed the morale of Kenyans, because really, you saw what was going on social media. Really, how can somebody be in ICU at the same time the person is in that kind of state? The other thing was about Margaret Wanjiru, the pastor.
Just before...
And she was in ICU for hardly a week, and people felt truly it was really like a movie.
Now,
it was like a video, really acting.
Bob, just stay on the line for a moment, because I actually want to bring in Musa, who himself was in that situation. Sasa Musa, kuna hii issue ya, when you're in that kind of a critical place, hospitali, ni mahali ambapo unaweza kwenda umevaa kofia, umevaa my headphones, umefanya nini?
I think first of all, nataka kusema Osano, ile room alikuwa anapita was in the room number 4, in that isolation room. Again, hiyo situation ya niliona kwa video, yeah, sometimes ni difficult kusema tu kweli, but unajua CG alikuwa kwa wapi, vile Kenyans walikuwa naitake, but sama onye, it is a difficult situation, siwezi kuambia tunaweza kwa pia na kofia yako, kuna simu yako, kuna nini, unajua, ni situation ile, ICU room, I think I was jipata kwa situation kama hizo, but I don't know where alikuwa wapi. But for me, nilikuwa kwa installation room, ukiangalia, nilikuwa na hiyo oxygen hapo. Senye sikuwa na kofia, Unaona? So situation siwezi kuambia liko iko wapi. Na vile Kenyans walichukua pia walichukua another negative situation. Unaona? But again, watu wanakuja na kuvisit, maybe wanakuchukua video. Mtu anaichukua in a very good way, anaichukua in a very negative way. Unaona? But ni situation yenyewe, maybe akirecover naweza tuambia vizuri. But at the moment, mimi nilikuwa sikuwa kwa situation kama hiyo TIC. Nilikuwa kwa hiyo isolation room. I think nafikiria sana the same room nene mwana sana akiingia. I was in that IDU room number 4. Ukiangalia hapo ilikuwa tu ni oxygen, your temperature iko aje. No, it was just a small room. Yeah.
Okay. And Seth, your comment as well to this. What kind of condition are the patients in? You know, what are they actually able to physically do, those that you saw? Obviously this were in the ICU is a little bit different, but from what you saw.
Well, I'll agree 100% with Musa Otieno. Like, it is not a moment even when you can speak. At the ICU, it is very different. You are in the intensive care unit. It is between life and death. And there are no games. And I won't want to talk about Burale much, because I think also the Ministry of Health did mention that they were not aware of such an incident. But I just want to clarify that I wish we were given, you know, an opportunity to showcase what patients are going through. But of course, there are issues to do with, you know, confidentiality. But the patients we saw in the ICU, they were struggling to live. And they were in life support. They were using ventilators. They can barely speak. Like what Eric said, the boy just kept on staring at us. And he can't even speak. And so it is unfortunate that, you know, maybe someone would take advantage of the situation, because what we're trying to highlight is that COVID is real as it is. And we thank God that, like the ministry and according to the statistics, that most Kenyans are asymptomatic. And that is why we also need to differentiate between an isolation ward, a general COVID isolation ward, and an IDU, infectious disease unit. And apart from the IDU, there's the IDU ICU. Now that is the climax. That is the last point. A patient who's really, really struggling with COVID, that is where it's going to determine if it's going to live or die. And so what we saw and the patients we actually saw in those wards is a totally different thing from what we've been seeing on social media. It's just that we can't, you know, highlight the patients because of ethic issues, but it is a dire need. And my point to Bob is that, you know, in as much as we saw asymptomatic, you know, COVID-19 positive patients, you know, dancing in the wards, of course they do that to just motivate themselves and give them morale. But when you are taken to the ICU, it means that you are in a very critical condition and it's just a matter of life and death.
Okay. Thank you. And thank you, Bob, for calling in with your comments and with your questions. Now, Eric, let me ask you as well briefly. You have covered many things in your life, from accidents to conflicts to riots to everything. Where does this rank, hii experience ya kuingia kwa hiyo ward ya ICU compared na zile story nyingine ambazo umecover?
Unajua, okay, kuna ile liniuma sana, ilikuwa Garissa University attack. Kwa sababu tulifika location, tukapata students bado hawajatolewa ndani, na then there was shooting going on and stuff. It pained me a lot kwa sababu many students walikufa, na nikitu ingeza kufanya kusaidiwa haraka kama government ingeact. So hiyo ndio ilikuwa ya kwanza. Sasa hii ya pili, hata sasa inajinishtua zaidi kwa sababu ile hata government askari wanazaingililia wasaidia students, lakini hii hakuna mtu anakuja kukusaidia sababu hakuna, of course, sasa hii hakuna dawa. So unajiuliza sasa hii ugonjwa inatibiwa aje? So wewe pia kuona uko tensed, unajiuliza hii ugonjwa okay, kiwe inatoka wapi at first? Unaona? So pia ni changamoto kubwa sababu they hata sisi ati ni tuko comfortable, tulikuwa comfortable sana pale. Hata sisi nakwambia, hata Seth mwenyewe anajua alikuwa ame tense, hata sidhani kama alikaa ndani sana.
So Sinta, now coach, let me come to you. Sasa nikuulize swali tofauti kidogo na COVID. Now, the task force on sports, which has been looking into how to safely reopen sports,
will present its report to government, to the CS on Monday. Sasa, from you, wewe as a sportsperson, what do you think? Tuko ready kufungua michezo?
I think for me, again, napenda sports sana na the situation hiko. I think hata kama nikufunguliwa, kuna kufungulia pia na stages. Najua, kwa sababu unapata kuna group stage, maybe individuals wanna come in, maybe as najua, atuwezi fungutua tata whole ati sasa watu wende wakacheze. I think we need to add sana, at least to fungo into group stages, jota kama kuna team, wanakuja in fours, wengine wanakuja baadaye. No, at momentum kidogo kidogo tu tuipatie mpaka maybe kutoka stage 1 mpaka 4. By the time tunafika 4, at least team is akwenda kuja 11v11, but at least coaches are kama kachukua the back 4, the back 6. Hivyo tufungulie kidogo gradually, because still na believe kuifungua yote bado we are still not ready.
Okay, na lakini bado you think it still is important kuanza kufikiria kufungua?
Yeah, because najua pia vitu zingine zimefunguliwa, but ni vile nasema with stages, because ukiangalia zile mkakati FIFA walikuwa wameweka na zile zimekotiko Africa na facilities, kusema tu kweli we still cannot match where FIFA wanataka vitu ziwe. But kama waza fungwe na stage na group kidogo, because when you come in and you are training four players, I think so kutakuwa na distance, itakuwa much better. Because mind you, hata sports ikifunguliwa, we need another kit, we need a doctor in each and every field. Unajua, kuna so many things that needs to be done, because we still don't have that finance. But ikifunguliwa nile, at least, mimi nasema sana, tuanze na stage 1, stage 1 watu wangapi, maybe team inacheza ni 4v4, stage 2, stage 3, mpaka at least tukifika stage 4, mali tunajua nyewe, everything iko calm. Unajua, why not? Because I think maisha ni muhimu kushinda ati tuende pale, tuangamize kila mtu na ugonjwa. Naona.
Okay.
But mingi ataka sana as a sports person. Tufunguliwe kidogo at least.
Sawa. Sasa coach, in other countries, wanafungua not just Evo Stages umesema, but they are also looking at the sports ambazo have got minimal contact. Ndiyo zinapewa priority, maybe sijui golf ama nini. Na zile ambazo there is a lot of contact kama basketball, ziwe mwisho. Sijui unaonaje hiyo order ya which games ama which sports should be given priority.
But for me, let's say my general as a sports, because the quantico bias ni kisema basketball na mina penda ball. No, no. But vile nasema, ujio, kuna individual, ujio, kila kitu kuna stages. No, no. Because hata kiangalia UK, vile nifunguliwa IPL, teams were like in Spain, team were like coming in, pepa na kujena wachezaji wana wana train, ujio, you're building your house. Mwana. But tukufungua 2011 at water mekuja at the same time, I think bado ni a bit of a challenge, because ndili ya kuna sasa mpaka next year. So I think we can start with stages.
Sawa. Coach, thank you. Stay on the line for us. We've got a caller on the line. Good morning and welcome to your world.
Hello. Hello.
Good Harun, good morning. Welcome to NTV, your world.
Okay.
Hapa ni NTV. Ulikuwa unataka kusema aje?
Ilikuwa nataka niulize Musa Otieno, kuna hizi maliki ndogo ndogo hasa sasa hivi wakati wa corona.
Ebu anakusikia, rudia swali, coach anakusikia.
Okay, nilikuwa nauliza wakati huu wa corona hii kuna hizi ndogo ndogo zilikuwa zimeanzishwa mashinani. Na kwa sasa hivi tunasambaratika kabisa na mafijana ambao walikuwa wamejitolea kuingia kwa ligi. Imekuwa kabisa ionekane tena hawana matumaini tena kwamba wataweza kurudi kwa ligi na mambo yaendelee jinsi ilivyokuwa wakati hii janga la corona limeshika hapa Kenya. Na ikiwa kama kuna mikakati ambayo serikali itaweka warudisha wa vijana wajite kwa ligi ndogo ndogo, sikwe zimepotea hivyo hivyo.
Asante Harun, ngoja nione kama coach naye pia amekuwa akikusikia.
Okay.
Musa, over to you if you caught the gist of that question.
I think Harun, asante sana kwa your question, but nafikiria kwanza vijana wana kwa vulnerable sana. Na lazima tutuko patient. Because whatever imetokea, hakuna mtu alikuwa anajua. because ukiangalia kama shule pia watoto waendi shule because of the risk. So mimi nasema tuko tu kwa patient na vijana, because hata kifika next year bado naendelea na whatever plans were there, but muhimu ni watoto wako kwa healthy. Bola ipotei. No, bola ipotei. Tuwetu tuko patient, vitu imetokea, janga imetokea. So nobody knew about it, but toga vile ministry itasema. But for me as a coach, nasema, let's just be, because hata mi na organization, na wamiss, but health first kwao.
Okay.
So tukifika next year, I think it's a bit tendelea tu.
Asante coach, and thank you very much Haron for your question. We'll take a short break now, but just before we do that, here's some of your comments. We are asking you about your COVID-19 heroes. And Beth unasema, congratulations, Victoria Namunyak. Okay, thank you very much indeed. One of our heroes, she was just with us a few minutes ago. Victoria is my heroine. Okay, Jared umeongea pia, tumekusikia. Thank you. Gilbert Kiprotich unasema, may the officer Vicky be blessed. Aya, asante sana, tumekupata vizuri. Richie Odongo, thanks God to that coach, you were healed. Okay, that's for Musa Otieno. Francis Afresh unasema, to God be the glory coach. Asante sana kwa sababu wamepata afya yake tena. Eric Ondiege, get well soon coach. Aya, yupo, anajitahidi kuweza kupiga full 90 minutes. Tom Boyer, your comments for constantly and consistently providing relevant info that is understandable by the general public. Keep it up, Doc. Asante sana. And then this is Charles Okere Okoth. Musa Otieno is my hero. He supports the vulnerable in the community through his foundation, Kickoff to Hope. Thank you, Charles. Coach anakusikia vizuri. David Kedode, amen. I grew up in a community. I'm a believer, and everything I do for Christ. What a testimony, my brother. God bless you. Okay, those are the words of the coach. Asante, David. And this one is from Zach. Get well soon, Musa. Okay, anakusikia loud and clear. And then Gilbert Kiprotich, anadhani tumesha soma hiyo kwamba the officer Vicky, may she be blessed. Asante sana. Okay, we'll be right back after this short break.
Juka University is the ultimate choice. With the state-of-the-art learning facilities, comprehensive curricula, you are guaranteed to achieve your career dreams. Our vibrant student clubs will nurture you holistically. Join our September intake and experience world-class training. Juka University. Knowledge is wealth.
Quality ya kipekee kwa bei nafuu. Faraja Premium Tea imeshika.
Change can be disruptive, but Business Daily has got you covered. From Monday to Friday, get evolving trends, ingenious business ideas, and the latest tech content in the new market dynamic, and exciting lifestyle content in the new normal environment. Business Daily, more possibilities.
Unajua kutoka tuwane, umekuanga na issues na mimi 24/7.
But ni ukweli, wewe ndio ulikam na baggage mingi.
Hey, ni kama wives tunaendanga shule fulani ya kuchange our spouse. And yet it just does not work.
Mimi sioni issue, okay. Unless ni mimi.
Okay, I don't know what it is. Okay, okay. Wacha mwa huu.
Unajua mimi nikigrow, budangu na madangu wakuanga pamoja for a very long time. I think like growth yangu mingi sana. So me, nimigrow na mamangu ndiye alikuanga everything. Kukuja shule, kunivisit everything.
Nigga, I'm helping you, bro. Brother, I got you. Darling, I'm helping you. Wakikam, kuna kitenge fulani. Imeshonwa. Wacha wakam.
She never takes anything serious.
Nairobi City has experienced a tremendous transformation in water provision as part of the war against the spread of coronavirus.
Tangu hii tanki letu hapa nyuma yangu nimefaidika sana.
93 boreholes in 3 months.
We had quick interventions.
We had water drilled, sunk, running out in a record 2 weeks.
We have over 14 million liters per day that has been brought into the Infopo settlements.
Find out what this means to livelihoods and the war against the COVID-19 pandemic. A Charms Media production this Sunday at 6:40 p.m. on NTV.
Now, the number of people in a church service has also been limited to 100 people per service, which, in which case, inamaanisha church zitaanza kukua na makanga.
Wapedwa wawili kaede. Wawiri service yanze.
Nilipile baiti yako kwa show kisema hizo signatures zimechorwa ng'ombe.
Yeah.
How?
Kuongea ukweli niliangalia list yake.
Yes.
Yenye my MPs walikuwa wamesign.
Yes.
Nikaona signature moja ilikuwa imechorwa kamera. Mimi nikafikiria pengine aliota akiwa jichopevu.
Ouch!
Ingine kuona ni Junet alikuwa amesign nikajua ni ng'ombe.
In partnership with the Ministry of Health, let's join together in following the set protocols. Wear your mask, sanitize, maintain social distance, and have your temperature checked each time you visit our stores. Naivas saves you money.
Okay, welcome back to Your World, and this morning we are focusing on COVID-19 heroes, people in Kenya who've gone out of their way with acts of generosity and courage to support their fellow Kenyans or their local communities. This morning we're joined by Musa Otieno, who is the former Harambee Stars former captain, now also a coach and running his own football academy, also helping distribute food packs to his local community. And that's just before Corona came for him as well, but he's now, we thank God, recovered. We are also, we've been hearing from Vicky Namunyak, who is a prisons officer in Isiolo, who took it upon herself and on her salary to produce hundreds of masks to support her community, people who could not afford these masks. We also have on the line Michael Monene, a landlord from Kinangop, will tell you his story in a minute. And we're also joined here in the studio by Seth Olale and also Eric Isinta. This is the NTV team that went into the ICU unit to bring you pictures and the stories of what it really feels like to be that close to choices of life and death, and also working with the frontline people, the medics, who are giving up a lot of their time, taking a lot of risks to make sure that people can keep safe, can recover, can get back their health. So let me start with Mr. Michael Monene. Now, we've heard stories of people who could not afford to pay rent and they were thrown out of their houses, some with children, some in the middle of the night, people whose houses, landlords have come in and taken away the doors and the windows to kick them out. But there is a landlord with a different, and his story was a big story here on NTV and around the Kenyan media. He did something amazing, and I just want to share that story with you. Now, first of all, Mr. Monene, tell us what was going on when your tenants started going through hardships. How did it all start?
No, you know, we are all in Kenya and this world, and we understand the impact of this coronavirus. Fortunately, my tenants, they never used to have, they don't have an agent. I'm the one who deal with them directly. So I know each and every one of them in totality. So when I found that there is this problem, I called a meeting. And then we discussed with them several issues. And then they had a lot of fear, because I could see most of them, they are in small business. Also, they are private school teachers, bar attendants, cashier laborers. So they struggle for their income, but they have never at any one time failed to pay late. So at this juncture, even without them requesting me, I said, now this is the time, during this period, to help those in need. And afraid in need, actually, this is the time to help him. So I told them that they are, from now henceforth, I would like them to focus on providing food to themselves and their families, and also to meet the basic need. So I told them, from now henceforth, you not pay rent for 3 months. So, but the money that you are supposed to use to pay for the rent, you are supposed to use it to buy food and to meet the basic needs for your family. And if need arise and find that the problem continue to increase, I'll see what to do. So even the day before yesterday, I called them, because right now we have the climax of the problem. So I told them now, because the economy was opened by the president, but they don't have any income, like the private school teachers, they are there. Actually, in fact, the school will be reopened next year. They have not been paid for the last 4 months. So that's the time I told them, now even I'm going to add you 1 month to get organized. So I told them, because I've told them not to pay for the month of May, June, and July. So I told them, even next month, August, you not pay, so that you get organized. You know, things are changing like that.
So
they have another advantage that I was a tenant one day, and there was a time I was locked out because of non-payment of the rent. So I know how how people struggle to get the money to pay the rent, because they have other obligation in their life to accomplish.
So, Bwana Munene, how many tenants are affected? How many?
There are two categories of tenants. We have those who rent living houses, and then there is commercial. For the tenants, those that are domestic, we can say domestic tenants, there are 29. And then the commercial, there are 6 of them. But even those, because they have very low income, actually they are struggling to make the ends meet. So even those commercial, I told them, they also do not pay. Whatever they are using, they use it to meet their basic needs.
Now, the gesture that you made is very unusual. What was the reaction of these people when you told them, I'm suspending your rent payments for the next 3 months?
One thing, they got shocked, because they were expecting bad news, because they were hearing from other places. They were anticipating, maybe I'll increase the rent. Maybe I'll tell them, if you are unable to pay for the rent, you just look vacate and go somewhere else. So actually, hawakuamini. So even some started shedding tears. So even that, I thought it was a small gesture I have, but I found that it had a lot of impact in them. They started becoming emotional, some shedding tears. Oh, so that's the time I realized, at this time, you don't have to worry about material gain, but the value you add to the human being like you.
Now,
today is me, yeah.
Bwana Munene, you mentioned that part of this is because you have been a tenant yourself. But I wonder, what else drives you kuwa na roho ya utu? Because it's not very common. Landlords are usually focused on their money. Some say they have also debts and bank loans. But what else beyond being a tenant drives you to show this act of humanity to people in need?
I think also it depends on one personality and the way you are brought up. Yeah, because of how I went to school, I was brought up by my mom, because I have also my mentor. So if I, because for me, my major investment is my tenants. And without tenants, I can't be called landlord. So I give them the priority. And they have never have any problem. When they have a problem with the payment of the bill there before, they used to come to me and we discuss. And he had put, I have told them, in case they have a pressing issue which they can give a priority, they don't have to pay the rent first. They address that. Let's say a child has been sent home because of lack of school fees. There's no way you can pay for the rent while the child is at home. We deal with the child first, you talk to me first, and then we address the issue of the child and then pay the rent later.
But now,
and they have been, yes.
Mr. Munene, but you're still a businessman. Didn't you worry that you're losing money?
I told you, money is not a priority at this time. It's life and good health. We can see even Italy, they used to throw money away. The fund that is useless. There are other ICU, and they have a lot of money. And there was a time I was not a landlord. I didn't have anything. I was not complaining. Even right now, there are other people who have so many rental houses. You see, but so if you value the human, and we are not here for life, but it's just for a while. But what is important? What are you going to do to your human being when you are here? You'll not be remembered by what you had, the way that you had, but by what you have been doing to your fellow human being.
Okay, and now
Mr.
Munene, if your tenants are perhaps watching this program, what would you like to say to them?
One thing I have realized and I appreciated very much. These things have affected every aspect of human personality. Psychologically, emotionally, even you see this education and the like. But for them now, psychologically, they appear to be a bit settled compared to the others. You can hear in every family how the things are. They are concentrating with their families because there are no children at home. Now even they have changed their attitude even to others. The other day they went to a nearby town in Jenea. There was a mother of 7 children, a single mother who was unable to pay for the rent and even had nothing to eat. They collected money among themselves and they went there. That lady had not paid for 3-4 months rent, which is 700 per month. They paid 3,500.
So you feel your spirit of goodwill has also, you know, trickled down even to your own tenants?
Yes. And actually, it has also started to extend to the surrounding community. And you can see even the other community, they are running us. Even if we're, no matter how small, but I can see that it has some impact, which initially I didn't know it will have that impact.
Okay.
So yes.
My colleague Seth wants to ask you something.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful gesture. Did you receive any form of backlash from your fellow landlords? Did other people take it negatively, and especially your fellow landlords, who maybe did they perceive this as a betrayal that you're in the same, you know, you're in the same, let me just call it space or rather class? How did other landlords feel, if you ever got to hear how they reacted? Did you receive any form of backlash from them?
Not really, and I didn't care about that because I did as at my personal capacity. But there are some landlords which actually started to do the same. So there are other people, not only me, there are some who have the same, they could, given the circumstance, they could behave the same, because there are some, but in a society, there are certain percentage who will find that by act is contrary to their expectation, as if I'm undermining their business. But for me, human value is the most important. So even, you know, here we know that there is Satan and God, and there is all those forces, negative and positive forces. So, but you focus on what is positive and make a lot of impact and change human life.
Well, the recent awards that were given by the president, the office of the president, towards people who have been termed as heroes and heroines, especially in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. I was having a conversation with a group of journalists moments after the list, you know, was published. And, you know, we were in agreement that you would have been considered, at least you would have been recognized because of your unique gesture. When you saw that list, and maybe, I don't know if you were anticipating to be in that list, but when it occurred to you that, you know, maybe, you know, you were not recognized, you know, nationally and by the president himself, how did you feel?
Not really, no. You don't do this. Even I do other things which actually are not known, okay? But you don't do things to be recognized. What my recognition is those who are receiving my sacrifice. Those are my tenants. They recognize, which is very important, because my focus is to them. And also, for others to recognize me, actually they have their own criteria. How the criteria they use to recognize other men. So you can't blame anybody. It's like grading somebody. Your work is to grade, but the one who is going to extend the hand is beyond your control. So you do good to the others, but the most important, what you have done? Have you glorified God? That's the most important. And you are doing on behalf of God. So if God can recognize you, that's the most important. Okay. And you don't have blame at, I was not recorded. No. That is not an issue at all. Okay. And that one actually make you divert from your attention. So you just continue doing good. Even if people don't realize you are doing good, as long as you feel satisfied and glorify your God, no problem.
Okay,
so I am not bitter or whatever on that.
Okay, but
I thank those who, yes.
Thank you. Just stay on the line for us for a moment. Let me turn to Musa Otieno, because I know we have to let you go. A quick word. When you came back from South Africa, you've been running your football academy. What have been challenges mekwa nizipi?
First of all, challenges mekwa ni coaches. Because najua tunasema in Africa kuna volunteering. Kwa sababu unajua numbers zimekuwa ziko big kwa hiyo community. We normally have like 120 kids who are coming in just to be given that hope. Unapata pia parents needs to come in because sometimes tunawaachia coach ndio kwa kila kitu. So unajua, we as parents we need to work with our kids. We need to tunajua na wanacheza wapi, what is needed. Ndio hata mtoto akigrow ama akikuwa mwizi utajua alikuwa anatembea na watu. Unaona? So I think just people to come in, najua kila mtu ana expertise zake and kitu God amempatia. They can just come in and support somebody else. Najua na hiyo whatever you have, not everybody is a coach. Pengine mtu anaweza kuja kafanya life skills, utakapoja kafanya computer classes na with the kids. Or particularly that morale na hope. So those are the challenges, and then unapata pia some fundings inakuwa a bit of a challenge. But so far so good na kumba ya the reason and the objective that tuko nao kwa kickoff to hope. As a believer, I think at the moment I'm very happy because I'm ambassador of Christ in this world. Now whatever I'm doing, na do your God. Now each and every time ukiangalia watu hii, na feel too happy, unajua? Na feel too, you're giving somebody help through the Christ.
Okay. Musa Teno, thank you so much for joining us this morning, for sharing your story, for reminding Kenyans hii kitu iko na ni live na ina touch watu wengi sana. And thank you so much, Mr. Michael Munene, for joining us all the way from Kinango. And we wish you continue with, you know, handling business, you know, na roho ya utu. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. And if you're watching this and you'd like to maybe reach out or offer any assistance to the people, our COVID ambassadors will be nominated here, whether it's Musa Rotieno, whether it's Vicky Namunyak, reach out to us and we will be happy to link you up with these people directly. But just before we go, your comments regarding your COVID-19 heroes, and this is what you're saying to us on a hashtag New Normal. Patima Thege anasema, good morning, great show. I hope Seth and the photographer have counseling sessions. Yes, indeed, the company offers them that that service. Mariel Malanya, my boss, my mentor, God is great. We love you, and total healing is your portion. Miss you as kickoff to Hope family. Aya, Sante Sana, that was also for Musa. Edward Lockidor, God bless this landlord for showing an act of humanity to his tenants. Asante Sana, Munene na kusikiliza. Be strong enough, unasema, God bless you so much, Mr. Munene. Okay, thank you so much for that. Another comment from Michael Munyala, until someone from their family or themselves contracts or dies from COVID-19, that's when they will know that it is real. And on that comment, thank you very much indeed to my whole panel for joining us this morning. We wish them well. Stay safe. And also, that was Seth Olale. We also had Eric Isinya. We have Isinta, beg your pardon. Isinta, tumekupeleka Isinya, okay. okay, Coach Musa, asante sana pia tunashukuru. Na Bwana Munene, asante sana pia kuwa nasi. Salamu zetu kwa watu wote wa Kinango. Thank you for watching NTV on behalf of the team here. Tunashukuru sana, stay safe, stay blessed. Tutakutana tena Monday 6:30, tunaanza na TZ. Until then, have a good weekend.
Find independence by training them in fish farming. It's tough on my back, joints, and can cause headaches. Panadol Extra relieves multiple types of pain. If symptoms persist, seek medical advice.
Every Saturday on Team Republic Live, we throw down a party right here on the baddest playground in East Africa.
Watch your Namala Conscience, I represent, and you are watching Teen Republic.
Ton, Teen Republic.
We bring you the hottest celebrity lineups to the hottest playlists across board.
Stay in the kitchen cooking up, catch your own bread.
With the most outstanding young entrepreneurs doing mind-blowing businesses on Grind Yango. The ship is navigated by the sweet and sizzling Tracy Wanjiru, the fierce baddest presenter Martin Kimathi, and the party DJ himself.